spectacle and was hailed with acclamations all along the line as it took its stately way through the packed multitudes of citizens. The chronicler says, "The king, as he entered the city, was received by the people with prayers, welcomings, cries, and tender words, and all signs which argue an earnest love of subjects toward their sovereign. And the king, by holding up his glad countenance to such as stood afar off, and most tender language to those that stood nigh his grace, showed himself no less thankful to receive the people's good will than they to offer it. To all that wished him well he gave thanks. To such as bade God save his grace, he said in return, God save you all, and added that he thanked them with all his heart. Wonderfully transported were the people with the loving answers and gestures of their king." In French Church Street, a fair child in costly apparel stood on a stage to welcome His Majesty to the city. The last verse of his greeting was in these words, "Welcome, O King, as much as hearts can think. Welcome again, as much as tongue can tell. Welcome to joyous tongues and hearts that will not shrink. God thee preserve, we pray, and wish thee ever well." The people burst forth in a glad shout, repeating with one voice what the child had said. Tom Canty gazed abroad over the surging sea of eager faces, and his heart swelled with exultation, and he felt that the one thing worth living for in this world was to be a king and a nation's idol. Presently he caught sight, at a distance, of a couple of his ragged Offal Court comrades, one of them the Lord High Admiral in his late mimic court, the other the First Lord of the Bedchamber in the same pretentious fiction, and his pride swelled higher than ever. Oh, if they could only recognize him now! What unspeakable glory it would be if they could recognize him, and realize that the derided mock king of the slums and back alleys was become a real king, with illustrious dukes and princes for his humble menials, and the English world at his feet. But he had to deny himself, and chose